Hi children, how are you? Yes, you are fine. And I'm also fine, children. And let us start the continuation of the movement in animals for the different animals. Okay, children? Yes. Then movement in animals of different things. Okay. Movement in animals. We have completed this one as a one part. But we have to complete the next part also. Okay, children? Movement in animals. Okay, children? So, here, first one we are taking as land animals. Okay. First we are taking as land animals. Land animals. What are land animals, children? The animals which are living on the land and survival on the land, they are called as land animals. Like horses, tiger, cats, dogs, these are all land animals. But what are the, how they move, children? They move with the forelegs and hind legs. As you can see this picture, this, if you see, the horse has this one is four limbs. The front one too. So children, if you can see here, the two limbs, the front limbs are called as four limbs and the back legs are called as hind limbs. Okay. So the first two legs are called as four limbs. The back two legs are called as hind limbs. Okay, children. So in the same way, all the animals, they have four limbs and hind limbs. Okay, children. The four limbs and hind limbs. They have their this speciality. Even the human beings, we are using the hands. Yes. So this is a four limbs. But the animals can't straight. They can't stand in a very straight manner as we have the gestures, right? Four limbs and hind limbs. Okay, children. Okay, now coming to the aquatic animals. Aquatic animals, the animals which are living in water. Okay, second one is aquatic animals. So they have fins. If you observe the fish in the aquarium, they have paired fins, means two fins. Okay, suppose this is a fish. One fin is this side and one fin is this side, right? So, paired fins. What is the use for paired fins, children? What is the use for paired fins? Paired fins are used for moving. They are used for moving. Like in the water, how you are boating in the boat, in the water, same the head, same this thing also they will do with the paired fins. Okay. And they have tail. What they have, children, at the back side? Tail. So the tail helps to change the direction. The tail helps to change the direction. So if they have asked that, how they change the direction? So they change the direction with the help of tail, because they have eyes. If suppose the fish has to move here, then what should the tail will follow? The tail will say that yes, we need to go here. Yes, so it is like that happened. Okay, children. Next one is in the tortoise, turtles. Okay, turtles has paddle like limbs. If you see this. Turtles have four paddle-like limbs. Okay. See, children. If you see, observe the turtle. Four limbs are one place and hind limbs are one place. Right? Under that shell. Okay. So, when you just observe that turtle, they have paddle-like limbs. They swim with the paddles, right? And they are also helped to walk on the land also. That is the reason a turtle can swim in the water as well as when its goals are out in the land also it can walk. Yes, and that is the speciality of turtles. Okay, children? Yes. They have paddle-like limbs. Paddle-like limbs. Four limbs. And have you seen the frog and duck? They have webbed feet. They have webbed feet. Suppose the frog is like this and the duck is like this. This is the webbed feet. Okay. They just keep on the land and the frog will hop because of the four limbs. Yes. So it's like a spreading of four limbs. Okay. That is called as webbed feet. Okay, so frogs have what, children? Webbed feet. I can write here, webbed feet. Okay, children, this is how the land animals move with the forelimbs and hind limbs. What about the aquatic animals? Like fishes, they can swim with the pair of fins and the tail helps to change the direction. How the turtle moves? The turtle has paddle-like forelimbs so that they can move in the they can move on the land as well as the swim in the water also. Okay. The frogs, they have webbed feet. They can swim and they can move out of the land also. Okay, children. I hope you have understand this much. Let us move to the insects. Okay, children.
Insects have scales, like if you see the butterfly,
It has feathers. It has scales, which are very beautiful in nature, right? And the scales, they move with a children, here you can find it out. They have no feathers or bones or strong muscles. Their wings are made up of tiny muscle. Their wings are made up of colored scales. They move with the help of their chest muscles. Insects such as lice, ticks, and bugs, they do not have wings. So here I want to say that the insects like bugs, like ticks. They don't have any wings, and they just crawl and they can move. Understood, children? This much you have to understand. Okay, their wings are attached to the muscles, and that they are not very much strong. Okay, children. So we have learned today about the movement in land animals and water animals and insects. Tomorrow we are going to learn about the birds, reptiles, and humans. Okay, children. So this is the thing you have to keep in your mind, that you have to learn about movement. It is a lengthier topic, but you have to learn. Okay, children. Thank you, children. Take care. Bye bye.